So it's good to be here. I work for corporate strategy and sustainability, and we are trying to make ABN AMRO a more sustainable bank. And I will talk you through some points on what we are working on. And it's actually quite exciting times within ABN AMRO, because as you may have heard, we have been working on a new strategy for the bank and a new purpose, and that is all about sustainability as well. So I'm going to share that, some highlights of that new strategy with you as well. So ABN AMRO and sustainability. First, why, and it's part of the question as well, why is sustainability such an important topic? And this graph actually shows one of the big reasons why it's so important. There are going to be many more people on this planet in the next couple of years. And in order to have them, to provide them with a livable planet, we need some new solutions. And this is the graph that shows that if we have all these extra people on this planet and the wealth or the welfare of these people needs to remain intact, then we need different solutions with regard to natural resources. We need different solutions with regard to energy, with regard to fossil fuels, etc., etc. So we can't go on the way we have been going on. Otherwise, we will run into big problems somewhere in the near future. So this is not long-term in the sense that it will take more than 100 years. This is short-term in effect for the next 10, 20 years. We have about 10 or 20 years to come up with really good solutions to keep a planet, to keep our planet livable for all of us. And sometimes I make the mistake in saying, well, in order to preserve the planet, but the planet will be here no matter what, right? So it's not so much this planet was here way before us, and it will be here after we are gone as well. But the question is, can we leave behind a planet that is suited for our children, grandchildren, or our grandchildren's children? Okay, so what are we doing about this? What is our impact at ABN AMRO? What is our strategy? What do we really want to do? And I'll share some examples of what we have done already and what we are trying to do in the next couple of years. All of you are clients or employees of the bank, so maybe you know a little about this as well, but I like to show the slide anyway because it relates to where we can really have an impact. And Solange mentioned in her opening already that in banking there is a special attention for sustainability, and that is because through finance we can have an extra large impact. And this is just to show that. So ABN AMRO has, for instance, a balance sheet of loans of around 300 billion euros, and about 150 billion of that is in mortgages, in the Dutch, mainly in the Dutch mortgage market, housing market. We have a really large private bank, in part thanks to you, of about 150 billion in client assets. That is a big number. That number will have an impact, whether we like it or not. It has an impact. And if we can show you how this can make a more positive impact, then we can actually make a difference. We're also making a lot of profit, 2.8 billion, so we're a healthy bank. We did our Q3 update a few weeks ago, and we're doing quite well. So we can combine sustainability and making money. We're not a charity. Our CFO keeps stressing this. We are not a charity. We are not into sustainability because we are an NGO. We're into sustainability because it creates healthy profits. It's a good business case. It makes good sense. We can help our clients. That's the reason we're doing this. Okay, so our new and refreshed strategy and purpose is on this slide. And it's not our sustainability strategy. It's our strategy. It's our bank strategy. So the purpose now is banking for better for generations to come. And the strategy is called accelerating the sustainability shift. And we've thought about this and discussed it with clients, with other stakeholders, with senior management of the bank a lot. Why is it called accelerating the sustainability shift? Because we're not going fast enough. We need to help our clients to accelerate. Of course, we're doing a lot in this field already, but it's not going fast enough. We've designed three pillars within the strategy. And the first one, for me, it's the most important. It's to support our clients' journey towards sustainability. Because our biggest impact is in our client portfolio. The second one is to reinvent the customer experience. We need to make it easy, accessible. We need to make banking easier, more future-proof. And that's the link to the third pillar, build a future-proof bank. And again, for those of you who have been banking with us for a long time or working with us for a long time, this is not the sustainability strategy. This is the bank, the corporate strategy of ABN AMRO. Within sustainability, we said, where can we have an extra impact? Where are we extra relevant because of our portfolio, because of our expertise, or because of our history? And the first one is on circular economy. I'll tell you a little bit more about that in a few minutes. The second one is on climate change. Climate change is a big topic. It's one of the biggest challenges of the world. And by steering our money, or your money, or helping you invest more sustainably, we can have a big impact, positive impact, on reducing the challenges for climate change. The third one was mentioned in the opening as well. I think human rights is a very important topic within the sustainability area. If you don't respect human rights somewhere in your value chain, you will run into troubles, either financially or through your reputation. That's a finance perspective, but it's simply the right thing to do. And through our value chains, all over the world, through our commercial banking activities, but also through our private banking activities, we can have a real big impact on trying to have a big focus on that topic. The last one is on social entrepreneurship. We need new solutions for the problems of the world today. And traditional companies are not coming up with these new solutions fast enough. We need sustainable solutions that include people, and social entrepreneurs have the skills to develop this much faster than bigger companies like ABN AMRO. So we want to support them in the best way we can. We want to team up. We want to fund them, finance them, invest in them, and help them grow. Well, not just for us, not just for a profit, but also for the ideas that they bring to the table. We've developed over the last 2 years three really concrete ambitions. And I'll start with the biggest one, at least by volume. It's on real estate. As I mentioned in the beginning, we have about 150 billion of real estate in our portfolio. Just checking, is it still working? Yeah, sorry. And in the Netherlands, we have kind of a labeling system. I think it's a little different here in Belgium, but a kind of a labeling system to show you how energy efficient a home is. And by 2030, we want to have all these homes on an average label A. And all these homes, just to give you an idea, it's about 850,000 homes that we have financed. It's about 35 billion in commercial properties, so commercial real estate, and it's about 2 billion of our own properties. But altogether, it's a big number and it's a big investment, and we want to help our clients to realize that. And it's a big impact on the environment as well. If we achieve this by 2030, we will reduce CO2 emissions by about 2 megatons, which is about the equivalent of 800,000 Volkswagens without faulty software, right? With real software. So the second ambition, Solange gave it away in the beginning, but it's related to our private banking activities, and we want to double our sustainable invested assets to 16 billion. I know that we are well on the way on achieving this. I think we will grow far beyond this. And we will definitely keep this momentum going. A lot of clients are asking for it. We've had a lot of experience over it over the last 14 years. So this is simply the right thing to do. And we've seen that by making it the standard, in the Netherlands at least, about 80% of our new clients say, of course I'm going to invest sustainably. And the other 20%, well, they haven't seen me yet. right? The last one is, by numbers, is a smaller one. It's the circular economy ambition, stating that we want to invest about €1 billion in 2020 in circular economy. And I mentioned in the beginning, we have about €300 billion on our balance sheet. So €1 billion in circular assets does not seem so much. But when we stated this, or when we published this ambition, there were no circular deals. There was no definition of what is a circular deal. There was no demand for it. There was not a client in the office saying, I want a circular financing. So we actually published this ambition before we had any clue on how we are going to do that. And for a bank, that was quite scary. At the moment, so we are about a year ahead, we've financed about 25 companies. It's only in total about 150 million so far, so it's still quite small, but it's generating a lot of enthusiasm with our corporate banking clients. They know that they will have to change certain business models for themselves as well, and they know that they will have to develop a more circular business model. But they are difficult to finance. So what we did, and we know this, we know that banks are quite traditional in their financing. So what we did, amongst a few other things, not just putting out this ambition, but together with ING and Rabobank, the three of us are by far the biggest banks, we developed some guidelines for clients that can help them along on this circular journey. And we've agreed as banks that if these clients follow these guidelines, all three of us will finance them. So we've made it easier for them. Just to one of the I don't know if it's a popular question, but the most asked question for me is, can you give me some examples of what you actually did? So I'm going to go through them quite quickly. We opened Circle. That's really nice, but it's a completely circular building. If you're ever in Amsterdam near the ABN AMRO office, give me a call. I'll show you around, or show yourself around. It's open. It's a wonderful restaurant, and it's a great story. We've also decided to finance smallholder farms. And this is the reason I'm showing you this is because this is not our traditional business. We are not active in South America or in Africa at a smallholder farm level. But we know that in our value chains, somewhere these people need financing. But we just don't know how to reach them or how to fund them. So together with some larger clients, we've opened an impact fund and a lending portfolio of 50 million for the coming years. We also know that the energy transition will take a lot of money, and we have money to lend, and we can make a lot of money profits as a bank. So we've decided to set up a special energy transition fund. It's 200 million. It was filled in a couple of weeks, and we're going to do more of this in the next couple of years. This was mentioned already. This is not a goal or an ambition in itself, but it's nice to see that we are being rewarded for the input or for the investment that we make in this field, and it's simply a nice recognition for us that we are on the right path. Our goal is to have a livable planet. That is our goal, or at least to have a significant contribution to a livable planet. Our goal is also, I mentioned this in the beginning as well, is also to be a profitable bank, because we have investors, we have clients, we want to be a solid and profitable bank. And by combining sustainability, future-proofing our business model, and joining forces with our clients, we believe that we can both make money in this transition, because the biggest money pocket is in the middle here. It's in the transition. So moving from fossil fuels in the middle to renewable energy will take an enormous amount of money, enormous amount of financing. And banks are in this middle area, or at least ABN AMRO wants to be in this middle area and fund these transition. Just a really short note on the sustainable development goals. Otherwise, some people might think I left them out. This is the plan for the world. And it's a good plan, and we're going to make it. We're going to achieve these targets, 17 goals, 169 targets beneath these goals. We've selected three that are extra relevant for ABN AMRO. It's number 8, 12, and 13. And after you've heard the first part of my presentation, you will recognize them. Number 13 is on climate action. Number 12 is more on circular economy. And number 8, it's called decent work and economic growth. It's economic growth is all about banking, and decent work is all about human rights. So in summary, because I know I'm running out of time, it starts on the left here with the planet that we are living on, that we want to leave behind for our children and our children's children. There is a plan for this world. It's called the Sustainable Development Goals. It's only 12 years. 12 years is a short time, but we can do it. As a bank, I think we can have, through our balance sheet, through our clients, we can have a huge impact on these three. And we've translated them into three concrete ambitions on housing, on investments, and on circular economy. So that's where we are. That's where we need you as well, as clients, as our private banking clients, to have a conversation with us if that's not been done already. I talked to several of you that are on the transition to invest more sustainably already, which is great. And so that we're on this journey together because we live on this planet together, right? And I just want to look at you. Do we have any time for questions?
Donc de hoofdschotel wordt zo dadelijk geleverd bij compromis à chaque table. Il y a un ambassadeur de ABN AMRO pour de clients qui ont des questions. Dus iedereen die een vraag heeft, er zitten ambassadeurs. Dankjewel, Tjeerd, voor de uitleg. Je blijft hier ook nog even voor wie vragen heeft. Ja. Het hoofdgerecht wordt dus meteen gebracht en daarna komen we terug voor de keynote-spreker. Dat is voor Rudy de Waalen. Dankjewel, Tjeerd, voor je bijdrage. Dankjewel.